Well, back in the bad old Cold War days, this next report would have gone perilously close to triggering World War III, quite seriously. The ultra-top secret computer system at the Pentagon, that mysterious five-sided building in Washington, D.C., where America's massive war machine is run, has been hacked. And as if that's not a worry enough, the prime suspect can only be described as not necessarily a friendly foreign power. Here's US correspondent Emma Dalymore.
Designs of satellites, UAVs, the unmanned aerial vehicles, cutting-edge military technology.
Is somebody out there robbing us blind?
There are a lot of people out there taking a lot of information. The attackers are ahead of the defenders in cyberspace, and we need to catch up.
And catch up quick.
There are attempted intrusions thousands of times a day.
The latest intrusion is the biggest yet. More than 24,000 Pentagon files relating to the development of a new weapons system were stolen in a single hack this March. Sensitive design files that have put the project in question. The Department of Defense says it has a suspect, a foreign government that it won't name. But the only countries ever named so far are China and Russia. The two nations with the current capability to bring America to its knees.
I don't think that I deserved it. Do you?
You can go to jail for that.
Just a few decades ago, cyber terrorism was just a futuristic plot in the movies. Now, US defense claims a cyber attack could be America's next Pearl Harbor.
It's now clear this cyber threat is one of the most serious economic and national security challenges we face as a nation. It's also clear that we're not as prepared as we should be.
Malicious hackers have already crept into almost every facet of government and big business. The International Monetary Fund, the CIA, Citibank, PlayStation, and America's biggest weapons manufacturer. The Pentagon's latest intrusion, frighteningly, isn't the first.
3 years ago, we found that someone had gotten into our classified network, and we didn't think that was possible because it's completely separate from the internet.
Hackers were inside that network, which runs operations in Iraq and Afghanistan, for months. A wake-up call now being acted upon. Today, the Department of Defense issued a blueprint for its war on cyber terror, warning that serious attacks could be met with a military response.
The advent of these tools mark a strategic shift in the cyber threat. A threat that continues to evolve.
America is confident its military might will be enough to deter any nation states intent on looting its secrets. But they're not the main sources that defense officials worry about the most.
Our assessment is that cyber attacks will be a significant component of any future conflict, whether it involves major nations, rogue states, or terrorist groups.
Terrorist groups who'll be tougher to detect and deter. The Defense Department will upgrade networks, seek greater penalties for malicious insiders, and is asking friends across the globe to help keep the hackers out.
Its failure could compromise our abilities to protect the nation.
Good old internet.